Guys, welcome back to another edition of the Tour of Insanity. This is episode 83. This is also part 3 of LJN's Advanced Dungeons & Dragons 9-part video series. In this episode, we will continue on looking at series 2 of the action figures. In the last episode, you saw that series 2 was given a really cool upgrade, a Battlematic action. I also told you that the only figures from series 1 that got the upgrade was Strongheart, Elkhorn, Warduke, and Zarek. Well, that's not entirely true. There are 5 more figures for you to see from Series 2, 3 of which are from Series 1, 2 of which are brand new figures. So what's so special about these 5 figures anyway? Well, not only did they get Battlematic action, but these were the only 5 figures to get Shield Shooter action. So we got Northlord, Young Male Titan, and Ogre King from Series 1. These were the 3 figures from Series 1 that got these 2 upgrades, along with 2 new characters, Mandoom and Metaflame. Let's go ahead and take a look at these figures. All right, so we have the first 3 figures from Series 1 to get the 2 big upgrades. Northlord, Young Male Titan, and the Ogre King. As you can see right away that they have these really cool shields. You'll see how they work, and you might even notice on Ogre King over here, he's different, and I'll show you, don't worry. So let's start off here with Northlord. Now the shield shooters, they all basically work the same. You guys have seen him before, Northlord. There's no change on the figures at all, except for Ogre King, and you'll see that here in a sec. But the big thing is this new shield shooter action that they have. And I'm gonna tell you right off the bat here that the shield shooter figures, all of them, are pretty hard to find. They're rare. Probably the rarest one is Ogre King, in my opinion, from my hunts. He was one of the last figures that I found. I mean, I hunted for a while, but they are a little pricey, but if you are a collector of D&D, you'll probably throw down the cash. It's not horribly expensive, but I guess it's enough. But he still has the same axe, and his sword, also his helmet. So let's take a look at his shield. The shield is in 2 parts, as you can see. I'm going to go ahead and activate, get the device set up. The front of the shield, his little hawk, if that's what it is, falcon maybe, it does shoot out from his shield. There is a device on the side of his arm right here. You press that button and the shield shoots out. So how does that work? Well, there is a hole in front of every arm the device in front of the shield goes into the arm. There's a spring mechanism inside of each arm. So I'd be very careful with these because I imagine they are very fragile and break. But just for right now, so if I press this button here, it just launches off. Nothing too stupendous, nothing crazy. But as you can see there let me take off his helmet. I'm gonna pull off his shield so you can see his hand. There is where this connects. So you can see there, go him down for a second, look at the shield. That is how they all work. They're all exactly like that. And I tend not to play around with these too much. So for the video, I'm just gonna show you Northlord, as you just saw him shooting his shield. Maybe I'll do it one more time. I just wanna make sure that I don't break any of these because they are brittle. And the shield, as you can see, it latches on the top and the bottom of his hand. Let's take a look at his hand again. And they've put these little notches on the top and the bottom of his hand. And each figure is just like that. So why don't we just do this real quick and you can see, why not? It doesn't go very far. It really doesn't, but there you go. But so there he is, and it's very simple to get on to his hand. If I can get my fingers out of the way or my hand out of the way so you can see it, but it's not too terribly horrible to get on. And then you just put it on. I'm not gonna push it all the way. Again, because I'm trying to keep these to last forever. Take him to the grave, I will. So there he is, North Lord. Next up is Young Male Titan. You can take a little closer look at him. And you know what, I'll do it. I'll go ahead and just launch all of them. Screw it. But again, same thing. I'll go ahead and pull off his shield so you can get a better look at this guy. Young Male Titan's always one of the ones that's very fidgety. But there's the shield, the actual shield. And from the back. And then again, like I said, same way. Grips onto the top and bottom of his hand. He's got that hole in front. Excuse me. And then it's like a lion. If I can get focus, there you go. Cool lion. There's that part. So we'll put it on him. We'll see how well he shoots. What the heck? What the heck? I'll do them all. Not gonna wuss out, man. But if it breaks, I'm gonna cry. And oh, forgot to show you. There's his mechanism or his little trigger on the side there. They all have that trigger. Let's go ahead. And he's armed. He's ready. He's the Young Male Titan shield shooter. So there he is. Very cool. Probably won't be launching these for a long time. And last up, for the three figures that were from Series 1 that did receive, this cool thing is the Ogre King. Let's go ahead and pull him over. And again, I was telling you guys, like, what's going on? He's different. Some of you might go, he is different? He's a lot different from his look from Series 1. I'm gonna go ahead and pull the Series 1 Ogre King in. And you're gonna go, oh, yep. As you can see, he went from being that dark green with, like, I don't know, turquoise colors to him, to a very light, limey, I don't know, very fluorescent green with orange and black and some grays. Yeah, big difference. And of course, his shield's totally different. His shield, from the first series, they sort of have the same look. They both have that same, like, snake to them, which is cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and put Series 1 Ogre King aside, and let's go ahead and jump into this dude. And very colorful, and this might be why he's so hard to get. Maybe it's because of the color change, I don't know. But he comes with the same weapons as he does, the sword, and he's got a mace there. And his helmet comes off just like the Series 1. No different except for just the color, and he's a shield shooter. So here's the front of his shield. I'm gonna go ahead and pull it off and get in there a little bit closer. Why not? And there's his fist. And there's his lever there to launch. So there's the shield itself. And where his shield goes onto his fist. And also, of course, the really cool snake device. I love this one. This one's really cool. Yep, same deal, same thing. Let me go ahead and put it back on. This one seems to be a little bit tighter than the others. Oh yeah, but it's on. And let's go ahead and arm him. All right, he's locked in, ready to do a shield shooting action. Let's do it. Oh yes, he did it, he works. So anyway, again, just gonna kind of slide it in there. So there you go, guys. Here is North Lord, Young Male Titan, and Ogre King Series 2 shield shooters with the Battlematic action, you know. And we can look real quick again, Battlematic action. Anything change on these guys? Nope, they still got the lever, and it's still, their arm goes up and down with all the jokes that go along with it. And yeah, all three still the same. And what the heck, since we're doing it, Here's New Mill Titan. He's rough, man. That staff must be too heavy. Or his spear, rather, not a staff. And last up, again, without knocking these guys over, is North Lord, losing his shield, losing his helmet. I'll write that by putting it back on. And see if we can get these guys to stand again. We get into the last two figures of these really cool Advanced Dungeons & Dragons figures by LJN. There you go, guys. Again, the first three figures that came from Series 1 into Series 2, getting the Battle Mech action and Shield Shooter action.
Mandoom, good warrior. Mandoom is a fierce warrior from a very strange place. He has golden skin and appears to be made of stone. Mandoom is often called to this world by magic users who need him to help in a war or battle. He always carries gold weapons and wears golden armor when he goes into battle against enemies of the magic users.
All right, here's Mandoom. Mandoom's a very cool figure like the rest of them. He may be my least favorite of them just because it's just all the brass. It's kind of dull. It's okay, it's not the end of the world. There is still detail there, but you know, not playing him down. He's still a very awesome figure that LJN did for AD&D. So let's take a look at his accessories. His helmet is removable, as you can see. Very cool. Nothing crazy. Take off his sword. He's got his sword, and I'm losing his helmet. It's okay. We're gonna take a closer look at his head anyway. There's his sword. Cool. And then he also comes with an axe. An axe. This is a hammer. Very large hammer for war. But yeah, very cool. I'm gonna take off his shield real quick, and we'll take a look at the figure, and we'll take a look at the shield. Again, detail's cool. It is good. It's not a bad figure. I'm just saying it's a little dull than the rest of them. He's got a little lion there on his belt. There's his boots. And then there's his arm with the lever for his shield shooting action. His other arm. And you can see real quick his battle mech action works. This is his back. His belt does come off. A lot of cool things around it. It attaches and detaches right here. And there's actually a small knife that's been molded into the belt, which is cool. But let's go ahead and take a look at the shield, and we'll check this guy out. I'll see if I'm ready to go. There's a shield. Very cool. And of course, shooting mechanism. Another lion. See, the same way. Very cool. Let's go ahead and get him ready to go. Make sure he still works. If I can get it on. Ain't the easiest thing in the world to do. Same time, I don't want to break it. So go ahead and arm him. If I can do it. All right, it's locked in. Get his helmet going. Again, he's another one of the figures that doesn't have a friggin' spot to put this. LJN, I don't know what was going on with him, but that's okay. So we're gonna see if he still works. He's alive. Let's check it out. Yay. He's good. So let's go on. Come on. So there's Mandoom. Cool figure. I'm gonna have his arm stay up like that so he can hold a shield because his arm wants to fall down. Because again, those shields are very heavy. But there's Mandoom, guys. Very cool figure.
Metaflame, evil fire giant. Fire giants are one of the many types of giants on Earth. Metaflame is the most dangerous and most powerful of these fire giants. He is very tall and muscular and has bright red eyes. Metaflame cannot be harmed by fire or dragon's breath. He uses many special weapons and wears armor made of dragon scales when fighting his enemies.
Metaflame, very colorful figure, very cool figure. He is a little top heavy, but nonetheless still another great figure. Let's take a look at all of his accessories that he has. His helmet is removable. Very cool shaped helmet. And he comes with a mace. Very cool, very large one. And he also comes with his sword. Very crazy looking sword. Would not want to get hit by this thing, man. Dang. But, yeah. Of course, he's got his shield. Shield shooter. I'm going to remove him off. This guy off. Let's take a look at the figure. Get in all him. Very menacing look to him. Metaflame. His belt does detach. We'll go around here in just a second. There's his boots. Some spikes on his knees. There's his mechanism here to release the shield. And of course, his battle mech action. His arm is up and down still. And his belt that goes all the way around. Looks like he's got some kind of a bag here attached. This is where the belt actually attaches, but bag of something, who knows what. But cool, very cool. And looks like on the front there, I don't know what that is, a wolf maybe? No. Didn't you know it could be? Looks like he's got some flames on the sides of his boots. More flames. Very cool. Let's take a look at his shield. Very nice. Just like the rest. And of course, on the front here. Looks like a wolf to me. The flames coming out of his mouth. Very cool. And the back of it. So let's go ahead and arm him with his shield shooter action. Lock it in. It's locked. It's good news. Put his mace back in his hand. And let's see. Does he still work after all these years? We're gonna see right now. Yay, it worked. Hello, great. All right, Metaflame. Very cool figure. Very cool. Five figures. All the shield shooters are awesome. Now with Metaflame, let's take a look at his packaging. You got a picture in front of you. That's the artwork on Metaflame's card. That guy right next to Metaflame, his name is Valkyr. He was, or is, this day known as a character from Dungeons and Dragons. And but they decided LJN to put him on that card to be battling Metaflame. But they never did make an action figure of him, unfortunately. And there's stories how people actually try to go out and find the figure, but they failed because they didn't make him. But it was interesting nonetheless. So, all right, guys, that is the five shield shooters. All right, guys, that's the end of episode 83. This is also the end of the reviews for the action figures that LJN made for Advanced Dungeons & Dragons. Episode 84, part 4 of this 9-part video series is coming very soon. There's a lot more toys to do, guys, so don't worry. I am Count Stankus. As always, guys, you can check me out on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Subscribe to me here, watch my videos, comment, like, whatever you like. I appreciate it. Any comments you guys like to put that are constructive, I highly appreciate it. As always, guys, don't stop collecting. Have a great day.